money taught me Spanish, make it on delay.
Okay, yeah, we had to calm it down a little bit. It's my shit right here. It's that it's that mink coat music. You dig?
Yeah, yeah.
My on my uptown shit right here.
It's the east side.
They got me back on my east side shit, my Fiji water and Julio shit.
Alkaline.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Shit.
We had to come back like this, man. We had to do it like this. LA Run in the building.
What up, Joe?
Fresh off his born day.
Yeah. 35.
The God.
Yeah.
The God of the cars.
Yeah.
We in here, man.
Yeah.
What? Uh-huh.
East side.
You gotta be on some fly nigga shit to do this right here. You dig?
That's me.
Come on. Okay. We got the feeling?
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody can't rock with this, man.
Oh, this shit. I thought this shit gonna calm me down a little bit. Oh, this shit. We gotta calm me down a little bit more. We gotta. Come on. Oh, yeah. Hold up. Talk to him. Talk to him, Kenny.
No. Music, man.
Stop moving. This shit made me want to sing, nigga. Keep rising to the top. What we gonna do? What we gonna do? Alright, switch it up. Switch it up. Oh yeah. Yo, we had to bring it down a notch, man. My blood pressure rising. I did me like 10 miles on a bike today.
Easy.
I feel good about myself, man. I don't drink nothing but alkaline water. You dig? Hey, nothing but alkaline water.
Yeah.
I used to listen to this. My granddad, man.
Oh, yeah.
God bless his soul.
What, 96? Yeah, Jay dropped that Reason with Doubt.
Man.
Man, I heard politics as usual.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Real music.
Oh, yeah.
Instruments.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know about this.
Okay.
Man.
We calm down a little bit. Alright, play my shit. Okay.
Fuck the whole industry.
Oh yeah.
Nah,
oh yeah. Harlem shaking shit. That's that Sean John shit, nigga. That Sean John music.
I never could Harlem shake.
Come on. Oh yeah. Talk to him, ghost.
I ain't stop, bro.
Okay. Outfit is 4,000 and better. The rhinestones in my Flintstone look crazy. Got me bouncing in this
chair,
nigga. Talk to him, ghost.
Legend.
Bad boy, thank you for the special delivery.
Oh.
Catch me by the pool in my Tony Stark slippers.
Okay.
Wonder Woman on.
Stop.
Yeah. Okay. Wonder Woman on.
Dutch dime, I was killing him.
Dip
Castle 116, okay. I was killing him. Them days kept a Chris Coke, I was killing
him. Oh, my nigga Puff at? Come on, Puff.
Special delivery.
Puff, what Puff at?
Special delivery.
Talk to him.
Sniff it out. Special delivery.
Puff. Puff, tell him, Puff.
Yeah,
Puff, talk to him.
Some of the best dance moves ever.
Bad boy, baby. Special delivery. We won't stop.
Tell him, Puff.
Alright. Yeah, G Dell.
Okay, we back.
What's up?
What up, Joe?
Got the young guy. Lacar's in. LA Run.
I turned 35 Saturday, cuz.
35.
God is great.
Nah,
I'm just getting started, my G. I'm just getting started.
You're all good.
Ask about me. Oh, don't say that. We here. We back like Cook Crack in 88. East side.
All right, man. We got to get back at it, man. We got to finish up that album of the year discussion.
I'm ready.
We gotta, I got a good top five.
I got a good top
five. And I got a top five in order. And I got 10. I got a good 10.
Good 10 albums?
I got 10 albums.
Shit.
I got 5 in order, and I got a good 10.
How you pick 10, dog?
We need 5.
Well, we said 5. Last week we had so much music that came out this year.
So much music.
So, you know, I was going through and I said, damn, it's hard to pick just 5. But I'd go ahead and get mine first.
Get it out the way.
My first album, number one album of the year, gotta be Pusha T, Daytona.
Yeah. I'm on that.
Then I got I had to go with the Nas, Nasir. I got Nipsey Hussle, Victory Lap.
Damn, my nigga, you on my phone?
Wait. I take that back. I'm sorry. Pusha T, Nas, Lupe. Then I got Nipsey. And my fifth, West Side Gun, Supreme, Blind Tail.
That was crazy.
Okay. What you got?
So, my top 5, right? There's no certain order. Of course, Nasir, the legend. We got Push. We got Nipsey. We got Rock Marcy. Behold the Dark Horse. That's 4? Is that 4?
What you said, you got Push, Nas, Nipsey. Then you said Rock Marcy on it?
Mm-hmm.
That's 4.
Fifth album.
So you, wait. Rock Marcy.
Mm-hmm.
So the one I was trying to remember last week was Rosebud's Revenge 2.
That was last year though, right?
No, that was this year.
Top of the year?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's the one I couldn't remember.
I'm surprised you didn't got Drake in your top 5, but that's a different story.
Don't worry about it.
So don't worry about it. You got it. And Kids See Ghosts.
Okay. What you got, LaCars?
I actually put them in order this time.
This guy.
Start with 5 for me. My 5, Travis Scott, Astroworld. 4, I got Scorpion, Drake. 3, that J-Rock.
Shit.
1 and 2 was close, man. I got Pusha 2. And Nipsey was number 1 for me.
Okay, you got Nip number 1.
Victory Lap.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good.
That's a good top 5, though.
Yeah.
Niggas forget about Jim Jones' Waste of Talent. Fuck.
Yeah.
It's my summer album. Shit.
I just put a little variety in. I like that Travis Scott, man.
Oh, yeah. That's top to bottom. Niggas forget that Book of Ryan, too. The Royce. That's what I'm saying. It's hard, bro, because it's so much music, man.
It's a lot.
That's why I had the 10, though.
See, yeah.
That's why I came up with the 10. Yo. That's why I said, I got more than 10, actually.
Yeah.
But I got that, I had that in my, when I did like a mid-year list, I had the Book of Ryan in like my top, like 10. I had that Freddie.
It's a lot of
albums, you know what I'm saying? Had that J-Rock, that Benny, Tana Talk, it just came out, so, you know what I'm saying? It didn't really touch me like,
it's that early.
Pause, like the other albums did, so ain't, you know what I'm saying, not yet.
That Tiana album crazy, though.
Yeah, that was if I did like an R&B, that's probably the best R&B album that came crazy. Out this year for me. That Tiana.
Tiana crazy. And okay. Like I say, I was against Ye. I'm still against Ye.
I had that Ye in my list. Got that Ye on my list.
Yo, I dog y'all on Twitter, yo. I'm dogging Ye on Twitter like
Ye everywhere. For real.
I'm dogging Ye. Now listen, I'm like, the album really sound good, though.
I ain't listened to it.
Yeah, that's a good album.
It's a good album.
So what y'all got for verse of the year?
You know, you was talking crazy about Jay last week.
Yeah.
Talking crazy.
I'm gonna sit down when I don't got a verse of the year.
Talking crazy about the God, but I'm going with Nas on Echo.
Okay, see, I got like a 5. See the Nas.
He heavy in that bag.
Verse of the year and pull out 5.
How you pick? So if you just pick one, that mean what, you just listen to one all year?
No, you said verse of the year. That's one.
I can't pick just one.
Verse is this.
So much music. All right, go ahead, though.
Because
you got
to push it. Because the Pusha Infrared.
Infrared was hard.
That was hard.
Push whole album hard, though, bro.
But like, saw me just pulling out one verse, cause that's one verse. That song is just one verse. So for me, that verse, you know what I'm saying? Probably better than that's like, cause everything he was saying, he wasn't telling a lie.
So about
at all.
The verse though,
he ain't lie at all.
Made you just like, okay, it's honest. It's all honest.
I mean, you just gotta decode it.
Yeah.
Like, far as disses.
Yeah.
Drake. That had to touch his soul more than the Adidon, the story of Adidon. You know what I'm saying? Because it was like for him.
Yeah.
You dig? So when somebody do something for you,
it was made for you. It's tailored just for you.
I know he had to feel it like I felt it. Pause. But as far as that Nas, Nas. Everybody talk, you know, the echo, but that the first song on the album that not for the radio. I guess because from you know what he was talking about, that's the type of shit I be on. You know what I'm saying? Black Kemet gods, Black Egyptian gods.
Yeah.
Like he just went through it, man. You know what I'm saying? Lupe, King Nas. I couldn't pick all three of them. He got three verses on the song. Five minute song.
Yeah, it's hard.
Song long as hell. Every verse crazy. The Buster, Bross Face Brippler. He went crazy on that verse. The J, West Free. Tough verse. You know what I'm saying? So for me, I had to, you know, I can't exclude one of those because they all like, those the best like verses of the year for me. So I ain't want to exclude nobody and say, I guess just pick one. You know what I'm saying? And you say you going with the Nas Echo?
Nas Echo.
And you don't have one of the cars?
Nah.
Okay.
If I had to pick one, it would be J, though. That was free, but I don't have one, a favorite.
Okay.
So what's the hottest song of the year? Since the year finna end? Like, what had, like, the biggest impact? Like, it was just crazy everywhere. Because I got a song that I've been listening to. This song is played on every TV channel, every basketball game. It's everywhere, bro. I know it's that big.
What is it?
Mo Bamba.
Come on, man.
I'm saying it's everywhere. It's everywhere. It's not my song of the year. What you think, though? What's your song of the year?
Song of the year?
Yeah. The biggest song of the year, like, you know what I mean?
Or your favorite song of the year?
Oh, what I would say the biggest song of the year... probably be what's the Drake song?
God's Plan.
Yeah, God's Plan.
Yeah,
that probably got to be the biggest song of the year. You know what I'm saying?
It's the most popular song. Like you mean, like the most?
That's like that got to be like the biggest song. Like it was like number one for the longest.
It was,
It's just all over the place. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's a tough little tune.
It's tough.
You know what I'm saying? Like but the Sheck West song, you know, it don't do nothing for me.
Me either. Unless I hear it and I'm out somewhere and it come on loud. I just start dancing.
I guess like the beat kind of. And you know,
it's
the cadence he got.
Yeah.
It's like kind of hard, but he ain't talking about nothing.
Nothing.
You know what I'm saying? But not for me though. I can't deal with it. You know what I'm saying? But it sounded right the other night though.
It did.
You know what I'm saying? So we concluded the album of the year anniversary, yeah. All right, so. Do we care about Cardi being Offset?
I don't.
At all.
Okay.
But the world does, though.
Yeah. Only thing I want to say, that is it's so contrived, you know what I'm saying? So fake.
So fake.
Like, but you know what I'm saying? What you expect, like, from Cardi B, like, she a reality. Like, you know, everything about her is, like, attention-based, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Instagram, love and hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I don't expect nothing else from her. For real, to be honest.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So just look all fake, you know. He pop up at the show with
some funeral flower.
Yeah, damn. Like at her show. She like the
yeah.
She like the hottest thing out. And he get in the show without her knowing, get stuff set up, girls on the stage. And I'm supposed to believe that's like, you know what I'm saying? That's playing.
Like
man,
he got,
you know,
props already.
Yeah, like somebody had to know it. To have it set up for him, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, they just, like that whole little, like the last year for them, like even him proposing on stage, you know, when they supposedly broke up. And he proposed to her. You know, I'm like, man, it's the old, I'll tell you, but it's like.
It's, how long they been married?
I guess a year.
Has it been
know.
A year?
No. Bro, man,
how old the baby is, though?
I don't even follow that shit.
Probably 6 months or something like that.
It's crazy to me.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's like a it's a like a reality show.
That's what it is.
You know what I'm saying? So, but you know, I just wanted to see what y'all felt about it, man.
Don't really care. I think it's all fake.
Okay. What about the Kanye and Drake? The beef again.
I didn't get it. Like, I was on Twitter and Ye just went crazy. Like, tweets. I'm like, what's going on? You know what I mean? So I don't know where it came from. It's out of nowhere. You're talking about somebody threatening his family and his kids. So that's all them. But Drake threatening your kids? That don't sound like Drake.
Well, he said trying to take food out of your idol's kid's mouth because, you know, Drake on that French Montana song, he was like...
No Stylist.
That's what it's called, No Stylist. Where he said... Don't wear no 350s around me.
Yeah, I like that though.
Yeah, that's tough.
I like that.
But you like that? See, like that type of stuff. You know what I'm saying?
You.
Subliminal.
You. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And he, I guess he said Drake like be threatening him. And I can see that, man. Drake, he like type nigga threaten people. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He sent he sent like the purple devil emoji.
Mm.
That nigga passive aggressive like a motherfucker. But I tell you.
Yeah.
He seen you some shit like that. He got the bread. You know what I'm saying? And he running. We got a couple gangsters on the team.
You do.
You know what I'm saying? But I don't know if he like gonna get nothing happen to Kanye. You know what I'm saying? But when I see that, that made me think about you know, Pusha T talking about Kanye and Drake's relationship.
Yeah, it's weird.
You know what I'm saying? Like on the song, like on Infrared, he said, when the CEO... When the CEO is blinded by the glow, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, them dudes got, like, a weird relationship. You know
Super
what I'm
weird.
Like, them dudes, like, BFF, like... like, well, I think Pusha said on the little interview he did, he said they always... Them niggas been dissing each other for, like, 5 years, back and forth, all, and then they be buddy-buddy. You know what I'm saying? It's, like, some weird shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's that new energy, though, that I don't like.
You know, the youngsters, though, man. I mean, well, they niggas old, though.
Yeah, I'm old, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, I'm into, like, all this new fake beef, though.
I don't know if they beef. I don't know if it's fake, though. You know what I'm saying? Them niggas been, like...
They don't like each other.
Slick beefing back and forth. I think it's, like... Yeah, they been, like, going kind of beefing for years, though.
The thing about it is, though, look... I mean, like... Ye had the game on smash. 808 and Heartbreaks, that's what, 08?
Right.
Then Drake came 09. It's been Drake. You know what I'm saying?
808 and Heartbreaks, my shit.
Crazy.
What happened with, so I think with Kanye, because he's still
doing his thing still.
Because he had, see what kind of messed him up, the 808s and Heartbreak was kind of like went left, and people was kind of like, it ain't, you know, people started gravitating to it later.
Mm-hmm. It was before his time, though.
Right. And then, like, when he snatched the mic out of, what's the chick name? Taylor Swift. He snatched the mic out of hand. That kind of like
fucked,
you know,
him up a little bit.
Yeah. He ain't been at that level since then. You know what I'm saying?
That's when he had Amber and the Hennessy bottle.
Oh yeah,
real nigga.
He was thugging. Yeah, that was like some, he was like
with his chest hair out.
Yeah.
He had the like leather button up
with the black Tims,
with the sleeves rolled up.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was on his shit. You know what I'm saying?
At the bottle.
Yeah, he was drinking straight out of the bar. That's my nigga, though. I ain't gonna lie to you.
That was real.
I said, Kanye's so gangster.
Yeah, Amber, and she was so different at the time. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
She was
so
different.
Yeah. And he was, like, grabbing the ass and shit on
her.
I like, he thugging it out for real.
West Side, Chicago, huh? Was it South Side?
I think he might be from South Side.
South Side.
But, that was, you know what I'm saying? So, he ain't been at that level since that, you know what I'm saying? But he had his best album. Oh, well, he got with the My Beautiful
Dark Twisted Fantasy.
Yeah, that crazy. Came out 2010. And
2010?
Yeah.
I thought it was 11.
No, that was 10.
That was 10. That was when
and he got like he got like 5 stars in like all the magazines and stuff. So that was like revered as his biggest album. Best album, I should say. Then he did the Watch the Throne.
Crazy.
Now, and then another thing that messed him up, was out of the Yeezus album. You know what I'm saying? That kind of threw him off too.
Yeah, with that trash.
Antichrist and all that shit on it.
What it had on it?
Antichrist, the upside down cross and all that shit.
That's on the, what's in that album? The Yeezus?
On Yeezus, yeah.
Oh, for real?
It was it was a magazine he put out.
Oh, for real?
He was sitting in a little, on the throne and shit.
Album cover, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. It's like a magazine cover.
Yeah.
Yeah, he
had the women around him, all black, pitch with fork tongues and shit.
That was on the, that's Yeezus?
That was Yeezus.
Yeezus, it's CD cover.
No, I thought the CD cover was like a...
It's a CD.
Like a clear...
It's a CD, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, he has some crazy art, though.
Yeah.
But the album was a CD.
Yeah,
it's a CD. Yeah.
See, people kind of... You know, it kind of messed them up. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, it definitely did. Because I was like, yo, because normally... All right, so before that album, classics.
Right.
Classics.
But that album wasn't as bad as people... The sound was just so different.
Yeah, it was... Listen, it was before his time, but we used to have him just classics, like top to bottom. Yeah. That's what it was. So it's like, yo, ain't no classic. It's trash.
See, the thing about that album, when I think it sounded like what he explained he was going through.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It sounded like he was in a dark place. He said he was in a dark place. That's what it sounded like. You know what I'm saying? But he still had some good songs. You know, some people that's their favorite album, though.
That's people trying to be different, though. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm saying depending on the type of music they already like.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Some people love
it. You listen to rock and stuff like that. Yeah, the album, you probably like it.
And that's when Travis Scott came in on the crew of Summer.
Mm.
And Travis Scott worked with him a lot on that Yeezus album. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, but that Yeezus album, you know, he had some songs on there, but for the most part, you know, it wasn't my flavor, though. I don't think, you know, it went for us, I don't think.
At all.
You know what I'm saying? But that's what kind of messed Kanye up, though. And Drake
he was
just
missing, and Drake ain't missing. You know what I mean? He ain't missing.
Drake kept going up because he put the first album out, and people was kind of like, man, that ain't good as I thought. Yeah. No, that's what the first one was?
Take Care, that's right.
No, and the first one was Thank Me Later.
Thank Me Later, then Take Care.
Yeah. I'm talking about Take Care 2011, that's a classic.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Thank Me Later.
Both
of them actually classic.
You think Thank Me Later classic?
I do. I went back and looked at the track list. Thank Me Later got some shit on it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot.
See, a lot of people like weren't pleased with that first album, though.
I liked the first album.
When it came out. And then he kind of, that Take Care, everybody was like, yo, it's classic. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And like Drake just kept on going. And he like just having hits. He just stayed on the charts for like 2-3 years in a row. So, you know, Kanye was descending, Drake was ascending. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
So
that's what it was.
Yep.
So, you know what I'm saying? And you know, Kanye had said it before, you know. My last album sound like a greatest.
Mm.
And your latest sound like something he said. You know what I'm saying? So I can see that little beef, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, but...
They've been throwing shots back and forth.
It's a lot. No, Drake, like the king of subliminal shit. He come with a lot of subliminal shit to a lot of people.
Oh, yeah. Drake be... I like that shit. I like that subliminal shit. Because I like trying to decode it.
It's mad clever.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, okay. All right, man. So, we was going to touch on the Wilder Fury fight.
That nigga cannot fight,
last time. You say he can't fight?
And he can fight.
He can fight. He can't box.
All right, my bad. He can't box.
Right. So what you think? You think he won the fight or you think he lost? You think it was a draw?
I didn't watch the whole fight, so I can't speak on it.
I watched. So I don't think Fury actually got up in time. I think he was down there 10, 12 seconds. But they say he was up. I think Wilder lost. He got his ass beat up the whole fight. He got outboxed the whole fight. Other than that knockdown. It was a clean-ass knockdown. I don't think Fury got up in time, but as far as going by points, I think Wilder got outboxed.
I mean, it's kind of... I could see it being a draw because depending on the judge, because the judge might have looked at it like...
How they judge is different.
Right, because he was walking. he was kind of walking down Fury. Some judges judge on aggression.
True.
Some judge on skill set. Mm-hmm. So you making them miss, like Fury was making them miss or whatever, whatever. And the punch that he knocked him down with the 12, that was the best punch he threw the whole fight. He fainted with the jab.
Yes, it was a combo.
And came with the right, the straight right. That's I'm saying that the whole fight. Like, why he not throwing the jab, setting the right hand up with the jab? He wasn't doing that the whole fight. You know what I'm saying? So I said, man. You know, I was like, man. Like, because everybody thought he was going to knock him out because you like, you know, Deontay, just like he did in the 12th, like, man, he'll figure it out at some point how to, you know what I'm saying? He'll throw a proper jab. He'll throw a proper right-hand setup jab with a straight right at some point. That's why people chose him. You know, he was, like, such a large favor.
Yeah.
But Fury gave him a boxing lesson, you know what I'm saying? But the rematch, I'm not sure if Fury would be able, because, you know, Fury, he couldn't get out of the way of that right.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you look at, like, Floyd, if you ever watch Floyd fight, because you set up the right hand with the jab. If you see Floyd stay far away from you, so you ain't hitting him with a jab. And if he in the way of the jab, he getting all the way out of the way. Because you can't see the right hand coming when they throw the jab. You know what I'm saying? But, and Wilder, you know, a lot of people talking about they think Joshua will beat him now because they saw that fight.
I said that even before they fought.
So you think?
I think Joshua will beat him.
I'm looking at Fury, though. He got like a dad bod. Like, this nigga beat you with a dad bod, bro. Like,
oh, Fury. Oh, Fury can box, man.
That nigga, like, he about 47 with four kids.
He 29.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
He's 6'9", though, man.
He's 6'9"?
And he moved. You saw how he moved around the ring?
How much time? Well, Wilder, 6'8"?
6'7".
6'7", 6'8"?
Yeah. Yeah. See, that's the thing. Like, people look at Fury and say, yo, man, I knocked Fury. You know what I'm saying? Like, he should knock Fury out.
Ain't
nobody else did it, though. You know what I'm saying?
Look at, like, boxing. A lot of, look at, like, he like one of the older boxers. Like, Larry Holmes, all of them.
Yeah.
Larry Holmes looked like granddad.
Well, different.
Now, with Larry Holmes, a little bit younger, he ain't look.
Yeah.
But them dudes, yeah. You know, Larry Holmes could fight too, though, back in the day.
You know what I'm saying? You know
what I'm saying? Nigga back then training and eating fried chicken. Like, nigga died one there. You know what I'm saying?
You had them hands, though.
Yeah, you had them hands, though.
All of Muhammad Ali wasn't cut up.
No, he wasn't cut. But
training different, though.
I don't think they was eating bad like that. Not most of them, you know what I'm saying? Think, if you look at any of the athletes compared to, you know what I'm saying, today, from back then, they all, the bodies look different. You know, they take different supplements.
That's what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, train different. Eat different.
Train different, eat
and
different.
And then this is a heavyweight division, so mm-hmm. You ain't got too many niggas walking around cut up. You know what I'm saying? Like, Deontay and Joshua.
Yeah, he got to have, like, a basketball body out there boxing, man.
Pause. Yeah, he came in to fight at 212. You know what I'm saying? Joshua got like a bodybuilder frame. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, he like got a lot of muscle. Like, usually heavyweights, they be like kind of big guys. You know what I'm saying? Because they ain't got to get down in weight. So they don't like cut weight. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to lose no weight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, but with the Joshua and Wilder, I think that Joshua fight would be easier for Wilder than the Fury fight. Because Joshua going to be right there in front of him.
So he flat foot.
And he ain't getting out of the way. And he's shorter. And Wilder going to throw that windmill. And he like just clipping
my thing
people.
On that, he can box though.
He can box, but you.
Wilder ain't no box. Like, no. I support him because he's from Bama, Tuscaloosa. That's about it. Because he can't fight to be. Well, he can't box to be.
Now, he's not a good boxer, skill set wise, but
yeah, skill set terrible.
He got that power.
He got plenty of power.
And if like just like I say, man, you got to get out of the way of that.
I say once he go in that damn rage mode, like he just swinging air down, where he gonna hit you with one of them.
That's what I'm saying. Like now, the thing about Joshua got that power too.
Yeah.
So he, you know what I'm saying, but sometimes man, you got them niggas throwing them wild punches like that. Like shit, man, you don't want to fuck around and get hit. That's the problem. You know what I'm saying. That's the only problem with, like, some, you know, like, at a smaller division, you like, could kind of brace yourself with that. But you ain't seeing no heavyweights taking no heavyweight punch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Swinging wild and wide. You ain't used to get hit on the back of your neck. He hit niggas
trying to get out the way.
You know what I'm saying?
And he like just clipping people and knocking them out. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we'll see how that turned out. You know, they are trying to make that fight. And, you know, they Wilder side saying Joshua running. Joshua, he want the terms to be on his. You know what I'm saying? His terms, because he like the biggest fighter in the world.
He trying to make that fight now because he know Wilder and Fury just fought. And they talk about a rematch. You know it's going to be the money fight. So now he's saying he'll fight him in April.
Well, they've been trying to.
Yeah, I know they had been trying to fight it, but he wouldn't take it then.
Well, no, they tried to offer him. They tried to offer him $50 million, Wilder side, right?
Yeah.
Say we'll give him $50 million, but they wanted the fight to be in Madison Square Garden. Joshua was like, "Nah, we're gonna have a fight in England or whatever, the soccer stadium, 90,000, and he wanted to give Wilder 15. They offered Wilder 15 flat. Wilder said, "I ain't taking that." You know what I mean? So they trying to. You know, it's the money thing, though. It's like kind of like with Floyd. It's like a Floyd Pacquiao situation. Like, Floyd, like, man, I'm not 50-50 in with you because you don't draw what I draw. Mm. So, you know what I'm saying? Speaking of Pacquiao, Broner Pacquiao, what y'all feel about that?
I don't think they really care about that fight, for real. I mean, niggas ain't checking.
I don't really care about it. I'm going to watch it, though.
I like Pacquiao. He cool.
Yeah, I think.
And Broner's entertaining, though, so.
Yeah, Adrian Broner more like a comedian to me now, man.
For sure.
Because he be talking all that trash and ain't really winning no fights.
Yeah, Broner, his career, like, one of the most mismanaged.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Young, flashy, about that money, man.
I mean, you know, he'll make the money if he win fights.
Yeah.
He lose all his big fights. You know what I mean? But his career been mismanaged, though. Like, he jumped up 2 weight classes. You know what I mean? He just, you know, they just did him. But we'll see how that I think Pacquiao probably going to beat him. I don't think he's going to knock him out. Broner tough, though.
Yes, I don't think he's going to knock him out.
That's one thing I say about him, he tough.
Who that was knocked him through the rope?
McDonough knocked him down twice.
But came in the ring dancing and shit. Was dancing outside on the side, walking out.
Yeah, he was doing his thing. He was dancing. He thought see that Floyd talk, they... Like, you like Floyd. You like the next Floyd that messed his head up, man. He not. You know what I mean?
At all.
Definitely not.
He, like, don't... He flat-footed. He don't get out of the way. So, you know. But we gonna keep our eye on that. Okay. So, you got the bill. Okay. Yeah, that bill, that's nasty. That shit nasty, man.
Blueberry citrus wheat.
Okay, that shit disgusting.
It ain't that bad, Mo. Hey, you done had worse before. You had some worse before.
Such as
a woman.
What? A woman?
A woman.
I had a woman that's... What do you mean?
All right, so I'm telling you is... You saying this is trash, right?
I said it tastes like beer.
Tastes like beer. It's a good taste to me, though. It's nasty.
But what you said about women?
I was saying that you have had somebody that tastes worse than this before. A woman.
And that is L.A. Run, Queens. All my queens out there.
Well, I'm L.A. Run, though. Oh, okay.
L.A. First Run.
I say L.A. 2 times.
L.A. Run. What you L.A. Run? We started out with your L.A. Run song.
Yeah.
You did? Okay.
I was there.
Okay, we rolling, man.
I was in L.A.
It's an acquired taste.
L.A. Run.
It's an acquired taste, though, right?
It smells like blueberry. It don't taste like it at all.
Everything's acquired taste, ain't it?
Huh? Oh, man, come on.
All right.
Melo.
Is Melo...
What we doing with Melo, man? What they doing to Melo?
Is he still on the roster for Houston?
Mm-mm. Is he?
I thought
nah,
he was.
They cut
Melo?
Yeah.
Game wow. Is he done? What? They getting rid of him or what?
They cut Melo, bro?
I think Melo done in the league, man.
I'm giving you one now, man. Let me give me a beer right quick.
I think Melo done in the league, man.
It's crazy because he came in with LeBron.
With Bron. With D-Wade.
D-Wade done, too.
D-Wade done because he on, well, how can I put it?
And they can make a mad noise in the background, bro.
But I think they kind of like... trying to put Melo out, man.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, because
Melo ain't in the lead to win no rings, man.
You ain't telling me it's niggas on Houston team better than Melo.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Melo a dog, man.
He a dog. No defense, but I'm talking about scoring wise.
Jay Harden ain't got no defense, though.
He don't, but he
none.
But he putting that ball in that bucket.
Man, this new NBA shit make me mad, man.
Yo,
like, I can't watch that shit, man. The boy be traveling like at least 10 times a game.
It's a different game. Like I was telling,
James Harden.
No, you don't.
I'm telling you, it's just, I mean, niggas just train different. Like everything is under the rules, but Bron get extra step every now and then. And Harden.
Oh, Bron, he always travel.
Exactly. You know
he travel too.
Who?
They didn't change, bruh.
But I'm saying, what you mean Harden be traveling?
That step back shit.
That ain't no travel.
Yeah. That shit's a travel.
Nah, listen.
It's not the 1-2 step. It's just going to the side.
Exactly.
Is you picking up the ball?
It's just different,
1-2.
Man.
He just 1-2. And what he's doing, the ball is still in the air.
Niggas
he ain't put it back down.
Every
he ain't
second.
Picked up the dribble yet.
Niggas this taking advantage of every step. Know what I'm saying, like, that's stepping, what they doing. They just taking advantage of every step.
Yeah.
That count nigga's traveling, man.
Carrie, if you look at the rules.
I've seen plenty of videos. He taking 4-5 steps, man.
Nah, that's not different. Yet. Going to the hole, that's different. I'm saying, like, on the step back, though.
That's what I'm talking about, the step back.
That ain't no travel, Carrie.
You got to look at it. Look at it in slow motion. What he
ain't
do?
No travel.
He pick it up. He still
look at that. Slow, fast.
No.
All
if he still up here, the ball traveling. Up here, you steal your dribble. You can do what you want to do with your feet. Ball hit the ground.
I think what it is Carl played basketball his whole life, and you know what I'm saying? The game just changing, so it's like, yo.
You know what I'm saying? What's a gather step? They got a gather step now.
A gather step.
That's a travel.
What you mean a gather step?
This nigga finna get up and do a gather step.
Crab dribble. When you ever heard
that's
of
a
that
travel.
Shit?
That's a travel. That was LeBron.
Exactly.
That was LeBron made that up. That's a travel, though. They always call that a travel. But that step back not a travel, though.
That's in a travel.
He picked the ball still in the air.
He's stepping back. That's it.
And he moving that. He stepped. Then he picked. When he finally picked the ball up.
He taking two
he
more.
He 1-2. That's your 1-2.
Nah,
that's just like me. 1-2 and 4. He just 1-2 into the side. You just gotta. They just learn how to.
I know 1-2. You do it whether you do it frontwards, backwards, side to side.
But you ain't never. Nobody ever did a 1-2 backwards. That's the dip, or to the side. That's
like when Euro step came in league. It was like that's travel. No, it's not travel. Just niggas weren't doing it over here.
Euro step will travel. That's,
you know what I'm saying?
Clearly two steps.
But that Euro step look crazy sometimes.
I'm talking about when it first came out though, bro. Niggas was like, "What is he doing?"
Wade started doing it because Ginobili
was doing
it.
Yeah,
but Ginobili his Euro like a big step, switch, and he'll twerk his body.
And then he
Wade was really the first
kind of like shaking you.
That was flash too.
Yeah. Yeah.
That nigga murder us in the playoffs.
Petrovic, you do that shit
first. Pistons, that is.
Petrovic?
Yeah.
Who you talking about? Talking about Pelly for the Nets back in the day?
He used to do that shit first.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Damn. That's a fun fact.
He used to do that shit first. Then I saw Ginobili used to do that, like, before they had their signature move and shit on NBA Live.
Yeah.
Like, they had Ginobili moving like he was doing the fucking Euro step.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, Ginobili. I don't remember that, but
they call that boy Ginobili.
On the game?
Yeah, on NBA Live. That was where the Lakers had what they Samaki Walker.
Yeah.
The boy named Smacky.
Oh nigga, you went back 20 years ago, nigga. Shit.
Yeah, that was on like
that was the year
when Samaki Walker played for him.
That was like 2000, maybe 2001.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And when Kerry Kilders and all them played for the Nets and shit.
Yeah, that's going back to back losing.
Yeah.
They had a squad though.
So Melo though, is he done? Because people saying he done in the league.
I mean, I don't think it's he done as far as his skill, but as far as them wanting him to play in the league, it's over with.
Yeah, I think the league forcing him out.
I don't know what happened, man. Like. I think they trying to say he like a bad teammate or
New York killed him, man.
Phil Jackson.
He went to New York just to make that money.
Well, you know, and East Coast kid too. So playing for the Knicks is everything.
Well, he could have got more money with Denver though. Well, he asked for the trade though.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That stage, everybody want to play. A lot of people want to play for the Knicks, man. Madison Square Garden and all that shit.
Melo, what he did, his game, Melo should have switched to power forward back when D'Antoni wanted him to years ago. Because the league hadn't switched to, like, the small ball.
Small big man.
Yeah, he could have been dominating at the four. You know what I'm saying?
That ain't his game,
on offense,
though.
But he ain't checking
mean?
No four.
What you mean? What four was it that he couldn't check?
He can't check nobody.
KG or four?
KG, when? They had KG, when that time KG was playing the five. They had moved KG to the five. And then Melo big enough
can't
to guard
nobody,
him.
Bro.
No.
What I mean, who could check? Nobody Melo. Checked nobody in the league.
Melo
like,
don't even play on defense.
Come on, man.
It's 10 people
about
that play defense.
Defense. Melo at the bottom of the list.
No. He ain't at the bottom of the list. It's 10 people in the league that play defense. 10 people. That you say, oh, he play defense. Everybody do the same shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, he could check. He could guard. And then, like, who gonna... And then, the thing about it, all right, it wasn't no four. It's not a four. It was, at that time, it wasn't no fours in the league.
What
that
time
was
we talking
be.
About?
That was when D'Antoni asked him to switch
what
to four.
What year is
four.
This?
That's 11, 12, 12, 13. One no fours in the league. That's just finna... That was putting work in like that. That was gonna give him problems like that. But they weren't going to be able to guard him. And Melo should have became more of a facilitator, more of a playmaker. He could do that. He could be a playmaker. But he...
Not in his game, though.
Exactly.
I mean, it is if... Because he a ball stopper. He get the ball. He face up. And wait to get figure the shot out.
Is he pass first?
He could be...
Or shoot first?
It's who pass first?
Melo.
Oh, he'll shoot. I'm saying he should have changed his game, though.
Melo will score.
He ain't finna pass that ball.
I said he should have. I said he should have changed the game. I'm not saying
we say a lot then.
That's what I'm saying. That's where the problem come in at. That's why people don't take the chance on him. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Then, you know, they kind of blackball him.
They blackball him for sure. He ain't changing his game, though.
No.
They go to China and average 50.
What happened? Yeah, he went to OKC. They had him playing, like, standing around waiting, like, to be a spot up shooter.
Yeah.
But that's not everybody's game, though. So, you know.
Because he molded a spot up shooter.
I mean, he can't be a spot up shooter. You know what I'm saying? He don't know how to do that. Yeah. He wasn't good at that.
He got moved.
Shot his worst.
Off the dribble with it.
I mean, off the dribble, in the paint, on the block, all that. He got baseline moves, all that shit.
He can score.
But you know, everybody finna like slow their offense down trying to get this nigga the ball.
Nah. I ain't never liked that move with him. Okay, so you know what?
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I already had PG and Westbrook. And Westbrook need the ball in his hand.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so we gotta keep an eye on my boy Melo. What about J.R. Smith? I see he got released.
Yeah, for real.
Yeah, so I think OKC will be a good spot for him.
OKC?
Oh yeah.
To do what?
What you mean?
A good spot for him to do what? Like
go play.
Six man?
She can start at a two. Or he can come out the bench.
Who they two, yeah?
Man, they playing, I don't know, Ferguson or some shit.
Ferguson, nice. He young.
Yeah.
Probably score about 3 points a game.
No, I don't think JR start.
I'm saying even if he was just coming out, yeah, they got Ferguson.
Yeah.
He averaging 4 points a game. You know what I'm saying? But he can come out the bench, him and Schroeder. And they'll tighten that bench up. You know what I'm saying? JR still could play, though. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of them still can play, man. Like, JR was a fool at Denver.
He was going off in New York.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, we got to keep our eye on that, man. You know, the NBA rough, man. You know, the NBA rough. They forget about what you did yesterday real quick.
True. Now, Anthony, you are a true Lakers fan, right? How you feel about LeBron? Because you a Laker fan, but you like a LeBron hater. So where your heart at, though? Like, are you happy?
My brother the same way, man.
Are Lakers going to make a playoff this year?
Wait, let me stop you. Let me go and stop you. Not a LeBron hater.
You a hater for sure, my G.
Prove that.
My nigga ain't even go through all that. I've been talking to you. You a hater. You a LeBron hater.
What did
hater.
I say? How did I hate him?
It's so much, man. Just answer the question, dog. Are they going to the playoffs?
He probably go to the playoffs. All
right. Are you happy with LeBron being in L.A.?
Oh, no. Nah, I ain't. Okay. Nah.
Okay. Mm-mm. That's good, because most Laker fans that I know, like true fans.
They hate LeBron. They love the Lakers now.
Well, some of the older guys are like, he all right, you know what I'm saying? But they ain't like crazy excited. But like these new Laker fans, though, are they crazy?
I mean, a lot of them probably LeBron.
LeBron fans are true.
Think about it. Well, LeBron, like, I don't think that was a good move for LeBron. Didn't make sense.
Mm-mm.
Go to San Antonio.
You don't think so?
I want him to make the Spurs.
Listen, nah, why would you come?
It's a business move, bro. LeBron.
I'm talking about basketball.
You're talking about basketball. You know, say, I'm talking business, about basketball. Yeah.
It wasn't good for my team because you got to look at it. I was a Laker fan before he got there, right? He leave, I'm still to be a Laker fan. We got a team full of young players that don't fit in with LeBron. So, you get LeBron.
They don't fit in.
Ball don't play well with LeBron.
Ball Ingram had triple-double last night.
I ain't watching the games. Lakers Ball look don't good.
They look good? Yeah. You talking about the last couple games where they...
I'm talking about overall this season, the Lakers look good.
Nah, they don't.
Comparing to last year?
So
they look better than the last year.
I mean, of course, they added like 6 new players. Yeah, I'm talking about my young guys. We won 37 games last year. You know what I'm saying? Like, we weren't like, we ain't win 10, 15 games. We won 37 games. They trying to get rid of Ingram right now.
That's a bad move.
They looking at getting rid of Ingram or Ball. They was trying to get a Reaser.
Ingram up and coming, man.
Exactly. KCP. They trying to get rid of him. He signed to the same agency. LeBron, he signed to LeBron agency. And they got him a no trade clause. He could veto the trade.
Who?
KCP. So you tell, that's why I'm like, Magic Johnson running the legs, you get KCP a no trade clause. The fuck out of here. This man might not even be starting. I'm gonna give him a no trade clause. You see what I'm saying? And maybe it wasn't Magic who gave it to him.
Yeah,
whoever gave it to him gave him a no-trade clause so he could veto a trade. You see what I'm saying? Like, come on, man.
I think niggas too hot on Ingram, though. He had to decide. You know what I'm saying? But niggas talking.
They aren't, though. No. Because
You watch Ingram play?
Yeah.
You watch him play last year?
Yeah.
You watch him play last year?
Had Ingram at point.
I watched Ingram. Listen, bro.
Ingram like 6'7", 6'8", long.
He like 6'10",
6'11".
Long playing point guard, man.
He's a good ball handler. He a decent shooter.
He can get to the rack anytime he wants to.
Right. His upside.
Can't get to the rack anytime he wants to because he's too little.
Did you watch last year? Like, that's most of his points came in the paint.
All right, y'all seen,
he's not a jump shooter at all because he gets to the rack. Easy.
He a slasher, but he ain't just going off the jump.
What slashers do?
Get to the rack.
He cut into the rack. Somebody passing the ball. All right, bro.
But he a ball handler. He was handling the ball. He run the offense.
We going to see.
He a decent player.
He's too high.
We won 37. No, they not. They not too high on. If he a 6'10 playmaker, long, he a matchup problem. You don't have to teach him. It ain't that much to make him.
And a 6'10 guy 10 years ago was a big problem. A 6'10 guy now, not a big problem with a handler. There's a lot of guys in the league that's big like that. So that's not abnormal no more.
6'10 with a handler like that.
Who?
Name him.
Who?
Other than KD.
Bruh, I'm not finna name these niggas. If y'all watch basketball, it's a lot of niggas with 6'10.
It's two. Besides him. KD and Antetokounmpo. That's it.
Them niggas 7 foot. They ain't 6'10.
Okay.
You think Kevin Durant 6'10?
Whatever the case, he listed at 6'9", 6'10. But them the only two people with that makeup that are like you saying, that you described. Ain't nobody. Who else?
Anthony Davis, it's a Anthony lot of niggas. Davis. That, yeah, Marcus Cut. It's a lot of niggas who big like they got a handle.
Anthony Davis ain't
they
got
not
that,
like not those like guys. That. Those like, guys can play the perimeter.
Anthony Davis can't play the point.
Yeah,
this dude was running point last year for real.
DeMarcus Cousins, ain't nobody give him the ball to handle the ball.
We saying big dudes.
We talking about people that could. We not talking about those. Those are big men. We talking about
like the three that we named. Like they can play the point. They can run the point the whole game.
They can run the point. Like. Those are totally different players from Anthony Davis and Cuz. They big men.
But you said big man with a handle.
Yeah, like they can't interchange. Like them three, they can run the point. who you name it, Cousins and Anthony Davis, they can rent a point. Just like
okay, Embiid, like Embiid. I'm not comparing Embiid with Durant. Embiid can handle the ball. He's 7'2". He can handle the ball for a big man, but I'm not comparing him with Durant. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
It go both ways.
Same thing. I'm not comparing Cousins.
Y'all put Ingram up there. Like I think they get too high on Ingram. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I'm saying
it's not an anomaly that he's a 6'10 guy who can handle the ball. That's not an anomaly, bro. It's not.
I'm saying they aren't too high on him.
That's just my opinion.
They was going to give up Kawhi Leonard. They wanted Ingram. They said no. The Lakers said no. They said, well, they was going to give him three or four people and some draft picks. They said, nah, we don't want that. We'll take Ingram and one other person. That's how the league. I don't know what that means. My phone.
This nigga terrible, bro.
Who? Ingram?
You, nigga.
Ingram. Ingram, he got his upside, man. But,
I like him.
I don't know what they're going to do with him, man. But we'll see.
I like Ingram. I ain't saying I don't like him. I'm saying I think nigga too high on Ingram, bro. That's all I said. But that's just my opinion.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
What he about like that?
What about the King of R&B? Jacquees. He out here capping.
Fuck no. No.
I can't name one song.
16-25.
I name a cover.
He ran into Keith Sweat at a show, and TMZ or somebody like pulled him. They pulled him and Keith Sweat over and they trying to get some shit started. And Jacquees was like, he the king. He said Keith Sweat was the king then, and he the king now of the 16-25.
He said Keith Sweat?
That's a 30-year gap.
He said Keith Sweat was the king back then, and he said he the king now of the 16-25. Keith Sweat was like, I'm still getting that bag, though. That was Keith Sweat saying. Nigga. I'm still getting that bag.
When Keith Sweat was considered the king of R&B?
I guess back in the... I mean, it just depends on who you talk to.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I know some people, I did some little research on Keith Sweat. I knew some people that was like, Keith Sweat was that dude. You know what
I'm saying? Hell yeah, bro.
Yeah, he was.
And then, Keith Sweat wrote a lot of hits.
That's a household name.
He wrote a lot of hits. Like, he's writing all that guy stuff. You know what I'm saying?
And they can't sing for real.
Hey, you right. He writing that guy.
He whining just like Jacquees.
He said he's writing all the LSG
said Jacquees
stuff.
He can sing, though. I don't know. I didn't listen to nigga
before. Jacquees. I like Jacquees. So if he put it like that, 16-25.
That dude can't sing, man.
Who, Jacquees?
Hell no.
Jacquees can sing.
What?
Yeah, he all right.
All right.
16 to 25. I mean, but
that's
what
age we going to? That's the age we're going to?
No, that's what he said. He said he did, that's his generation, 16 to 25. That's why I say.
How old are you? Like 22?
Maybe 21? Something like that. But if he from 16 to 25, I'd give him that. Cause I can't name nobody else 16 to 25.
Hell no.
You can't say you the R&B for, I mean the king of R&B for age.
He said
group.
For his he said for his generation. That what he said. I'm king R&B for my generation. So
his generation, I guess.
So he ain't trying to, like, you know, he ain't say he better than Chris Brown and,
cause he ain't,
R. Kelly.
That's
either you the king of R&B or you ain't. Ain't wait, for no age group or nothing.
Well, I mean, if that what you want, if you say you the king for your generation,
nah,
you could be the king for your generation. You know
like,
what I'm saying?
It's like a nigga saying he the prince of the South. Remember that shit? I ain't the king of the South, but I'm the prince because I'm young.
Little Scrappy said he the prince of the South.
Hey, that's what I'm saying. That nigga. Who?
Cause
who?
He knew he wasn't the king.
Yeah.
I thought he.
Know what T.I. said? T.I. say he the king of the South. He say I'm the king of the South for Decatur, Atlanta. Decatur, Georgia, I mean.
Yeah.
Who, T.I.?
Yeah. He the king of the South. The whole South.
Yeah, he said.
Not a certain region, not an age limit.
I mean, but that's different, though. Because the king of the South.
You the king, period, or you ain't.
Nah, you be king for that time in the, like, if
so
it was,
I mean, Bow was the king of rap because he was a kid. Bow Wow is the king of rap.
King of the kid rap.
King of the kid rap.
At that time.
Yeah, Bow Wow had some hits, some joints.
You say that? Yeah. But I'm saying.
Bow Wow ain't right now.
Just like you got a king.
He ain't right shit.
Bow Wow ain't right a damn thing.
If you look at the king, let's say like a king of a country, you still the king, but you might not be the king in 5 years, but you ain't the king no more. You was the king. So he's saying for his generation. Right.
That was that one king.
So, Keith Sweat, the king in the 80s.
It wasn't him being the king of South Side and the young guy being the king of the East Side.
No.
Like, he was the king over everything.
Who you talking about?
You saying the king, period.
That's what I'm saying. But that was still for like a generation. He was the king for 20 years.
I don't even see.
And then died. And then somebody else.
Had a conversation because, like, I say.
It wasn't he created the conversation. Yeah.
All right, so king of the 80s of R&B is like, man, there's some good music in the 80s. You know what I mean? So it's like the 90s.
Yeah, I mean, but if Keith Sweat said I was the king in the 80s, can you say, nah, you wasn't? Or I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know.
All right, so really? The only thing that
Randy's
I can say...
can't say nothing about Kelly, though.
R. Kelly, that's it. That's what I'm saying. That's the only thing I know, like, for sure.
The 2000s, got to go Usher.
Shh, Kelly was still there.
But he wasn't doing what Usher was doing in the 2000s.
2000 what, though? Because early 2000, Kelly was still there.
He was there, but he went... Usher put out, what, 8702?
That's what, 2003?
No. That was 2001.
We was in high school then.
Confessions, 03.
No, Confession, we was in school still.
No. When Confession came out. 03 or 04. Yeah.
What was on Confession? Let It Burn?
You probably in college.
No, we was in school when Let It Burn came out, cuz.
No, we wasn't.
Yeah, we was.
I think we was.
Yes, we was.
I ain't 100% sure.
We was in school when Let It Burn came out.
Nigga, well.
No, we wasn't.
He probably was in college. He's saying school.
We was in school.
No, high school?
High school when Let It Burn came out, cuz.
No.
Yes, we were. Look it up. We was at school when Let It Burn came out, cuz.
I hate to look up shit I already know. But
our 90s was R. Kelly, right?
Yeah,
for sure.
Clear.
No question. 2000s, though, right? So from 2000 to 2010.
Confession, what'd that say?
What's that?
04. Yeah.
So.
Carl was in school somewhere. We was working somewhere. Carl was in college. That nigga. So school for him was different.
So. Kelly, Usher, 2000s.
So 2000?
At least the first 5 years, though. You know what I'm saying? Usher, because he put that Confessions album out. And that kind of shut shit down. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What else?
So 2005,
like,
though.
Chris Brown kind of. See, Chris I say Chris Brown, like, after, like, 10. I say 10 and on. 10 and on for Chris Brown. Because he had the little situation in 09 with Rihanna.
Yeah.
So 10 had the Deuces song came, kind of put him back, got him back. You know what I'm saying? And then he still didn't get back. I'm trying to remember. It might have been like 11.
We're talking to King of R&B, and for some reason I'm thinking about Max B. Ooh.
Ow.
Yeah.
Biggie.
Big Avail, man.
You know what I'm saying? But free Biggie.
Free Biggie.
But yeah, man, that R&B talk, man. You know, they weren't talking about. They don't consider Weeknd as an R&B artist.
Shit, why not?
Say he pop.
Shit, Drake is too. We talking about it. We being real about
say
it.
Say Weeknd pop.
That's what they say.
He put out a lot of pop music.
He be singing his ass out, man.
Yeah, he do.
What that one album came out?
The first one? The trilogy?
I don't know, man. One of the albums.
House of Balloon.
Nah. I ain't talking about that. I think it's some shit. 2015, whatever the album was.
I like Party Next Door.
I made love to that whole album.
The trilogy album?
Nah, the one came out. He had them songs on that soundtrack.
And he said the whole album. Niggas be lying. Niggas be lying. Niggas said the whole album. Like, trying to trick somebody.
How many songs was that?
It had to be two. It had to be two.
About three. About three songs.
Hey,
yeah. A little sample.
It's an 8-minute joint. So yeah.
A little sample disc.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah. I got about 10. And I said, damn, the album's still on.
10? Fuck you with Drake.
See, nigga, eating for 7.
Yeah. So you about right. They even out.
Hey,
they even
listen,
out.
Bro. That's the go-to. 7-3.
Come on, man.
7.
Come on, man. Stop it.
Yeah, Karen. Stop it.
All right.
We ain't gonna get it.
So, who the king of R&B?
R. Kelly.
Right now.
Okay.
But hold on, Mo. The '90s.
Right now, Chris Brown.
Wait. The '90s, though. Nigga, Bobby Brown was that. What you mean? Bobby Brown.
That was the 80s. That was the 80s.
Album came out when, bro?
87.
92, wasn't it? The big album was 92, wasn't it?
No, that was like 87 or 88. Maybe 88.
Well, My Prerogative.
My Prerogative?
Yeah, Don't Be Cruel is the album.
Yeah.
Came out 88. Or 89, it's one of the two. His first album, came out 86. The Bobby Brown album.
And they niggas old.
You know what I'm saying? He, that Don't Be Cruel, though, was classic.
Yeah.
Yeah, that Don't Be Cruel. That was classic. But, yeah, man, we'll see what's up with that King R&B, man. That King R&B talk. My boy, what's his name again? Jacquees.
That nigga like 4'8".
Yeah.
Yeah, punch that little nigga in the face.
With a million teeth in the mouth.
Kevin Hart, Oscars.
Mm.
Y'all heard about that?
Yeah.
What's up with it? Kevin, they trying to bully him. The LGBT community.
They some gangsters too.
Want to make him apologize for some stuff he tweeted 10 years ago. And he already apologized for it.
I wouldn't apologize no more.
So he said he wasn't going to apologize.
See,
then he turned around and apologized.
That's why I'm lost with that.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, man. They run Hollywood.
They do. They really do, man.
You know what I mean? How many movies Kevin Hart had last year? Or this year or whatever?
I lost count, man.
What's the last movie? Was the Night School movie?
Yeah, that's most recent, I think.
Y'all saw that?
Nah, I don't go to movies no more. Yo, we had we had a conversation the other day, though. Like, remember when you was younger, like even early 20s, you get for the movies?
Oh, yeah.
Get an outfit for the movies.
That was the thing to do. That's what we did.
Now I'm like, nigga, sweatpants and a hoodie, like, comfortable.
We hit the mall.
Yeah, get an
go
outfit.
Go across the street to the movies.
Get an outfit for the movies when it's dark and, like, can't nobody see you in there.
Yeah. I hate the movies now.
Yeah, I ain't going to the movies. I'm Redbox all day. Now, certain movies
Red
I do support.
Box.
Yeah.
Redbox. Nigga, they still got Redbox?
Still got Redbox.
Still got Redbox.
Say Redbox.
I'm Redbox all day.
Oh, I ain't touched the DVD, nigga. I don't know. When the last time I touched the DVD?
Yeah.
I got like 1,000 DVDs.
Yeah.
I ain't watched a DVD in like 3-4 years.
I think the last Redbox I got was the Black Klansman. That was a good movie.
Cuz said the Redbox.
You actually go to the Redbox and get them out?
Yeah.
Why you just won't get online then? I think they got like a website or something.
Yeah, I don't do all that. I just go.
Nostalgia.
He don't do all that.
He like that old school feel.
He said he don't do all that.
Yeah.
He gonna just go get the box, get the, what is it? The DVD out the Red Box. That's fun.
The physical joint. Gotta touch it.
Black Klansman.
That's a good movie.
Man, I was trying to watch it, man. I kind of like fell asleep on it a couple times.
I fall asleep on everything, man.
Normally I do. Now, I'm gonna tell y'all. The first movie I watched all the way through in like years was Black Panther. Mm. I'm talking about, I'm up like this. Like, oh, man, this shit is good.
I fell asleep on it at the movie, man.
Oh, for real? Okay.
Yeah. Like, for a quick little second.
I'm at the house with it. No. I had the movies with it. Yeah. At the movies.
Nah, I ain't been to the movies.
At the summit.
I ain't been to the movies, man.
They said it's a new spot up in, I think, Vestavia. They got the drinks, the food, and everything.
They knew it was just the rain. They did
change the name though, right? It's a new company. So they like serving liquor though.
Yeah.
And food.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like burgers and steaks and shit.
Kind of like the little spot they had in where they got in Georgia.
Yeah, exactly. I ain't been to it yet.
Center Bistro. I went there like 2012.
That shit kind of tight though.
Yeah.
I've been a bit asleep though.
Yeah, really. So they get you, like you eating right there, like you gonna get full.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like you're on a real date.
Yeah.
Like you get your dinner in the movie too.
Yeah.
Like they gonna get you full and you gonna fall asleep and shit.
What the ticket is though?
I ain't been to that one. My whole ticket when I went was probably like, and all include the movie tickets, came out like maybe $70.
I remember it, man.
You know what I'm saying? But I had food, two people, food, drinks, ticket, all that shit. Valet parking.
Oh, you fancy. Mm. I remember going on dates, man. Early 20s. $100 easy. Niggas was dating back then, though.
Yeah.
That's why I tell people now, like, all right, so niggas wasn't dating back then. Like, niggas was broke back then. Like, these niggas talking about some, they got to go to Hoover now. Like, bruh, 10, 15 years ago, y'all wasn't in Hoover. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all was not in them restaurants, bruh. Y'all wasn't going to Firebirds back then. J. Alexander back then. But
didn't even know what it was.
Now you got to go. I was in there. I ain't see none of y'all in there. Yeah. I'm in there every week. I ain't see none of y'all. Some niggas like, I got to go to Hoover. Bro, you ain't been going to Hoover like that.
Yeah.
Hey. You ain't been going there. You ain't been.
I'm done. All right,
I'm sorry.
Shit,
yeah,
though.
I'm sorry, man. Like, you know,
I seen some shit on Snap today.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
I just say, man. Yeah, y'all ain't been going out there.
I was there like, all right, man. I ain't even.
Mo, tell him, Mo. We've been going out there since we was, 21, 22?
Oh, yeah.
Early. Yeah. They went out there, Mo, but now you got to go.
Oh, they got to. People say they got to go?
They got to go. I have talking to a little chick. I got to go. No, you ain't got to go to Hoover. But that's
what?
Different. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. I just got lit.
I mean,
I saw something. I mean, got to go.
Yeah, but Kevin Hart though, man. Speaking of movies, Kevin Hart. They bullied him, man. They punked him into.
I wonder. Yeah.
They punked. He apologized, man. Again.
See, man. Drinking that Kool Aid, man. Hey, you messed up out here.
Yeah, they got him.
You know what I mean? All the success you got, man, but you ain't got, I mean, you know. If they say jump, how high?
Yeah, they got him bucking, man. You know what I'm saying? You got to stand your ground. But he tried to stand his ground
at first. He did at first, yeah.
And then, you know, he ended up.
I saluted him, man.
I mean, see, it's kind of tricky when you get to playing around, you know what I'm saying, those type of.
It's a different ball game.
Like, you kind of be like, I don't know, man, you kind of be. Playing both sides of the fence to a certain degree.
Man, you can't, man.
Yeah, because he all the way corporate. You
exactly.
Know what I mean? Then he got his little laugh out loud network. So, you know, you kind of got to play to their tune. When they say apologize, you got to say, damn,
exactly.
Okay. You know what I mean?
That's one of the things why, you know, I definitely respected Dave Chappelle. I'm out of here.
See what I think? See, I think Kevin should have never acknowledged it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He should have waited. He shouldn't have did a video and tweeted. He shouldn't have said nothing.
I just never understood though. What's the big thing for you to host the Oscars though? Like,
I mean, you know, people had a bucket list.
I guess.
You know what I'm saying? You know, black people.
But the Oscars, I mean, they ain't respecting us anyway. You know what I mean?
Yeah, black people like Oscars and Grammys, you know what I mean?
We lost.
We just hold that shit to like a high standard, like you feel like you've been accepted or whatever. So,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's where that come in, you know? That's still that PTSD.
I was going to say that.
You know what I mean? You know, you just want master to pat you on the head.
Tell them what it means.
Say
though.
You did good. Post traumatic slave disorder.
Yeah.
You know, master pat you on the head, say, you did good with this movie. Like, what they did,
nigga.
Like the other year, when they did the Oscar So White or whatever it was.
Yeah.
And then everybody supposedly boycotted it. Then the next year, then they get movie of the year.
Yeah.
Wow, man, now they.
Oh, yeah, they fishing.
You
out
know what I'm saying?
Out of all the movies that came out that year.
Yeah.
But that was the.
So they picked the one. With all the gay stuff going on.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So, you know, you got to pay attention to the.
You got to, bro.
The agenda and the signs. You know, they, you know, okay, we'll give you one, but we ain't going to give you one. But,
talking,
you know, they showing
something.
The black men, yeah, in a feminine light. You know what I mean?
Early, young.
That movie wasn't even big, man.
Yeah. I haven't even seen the movie.
I seen the movie.
But I don't know if the kids getting molested or something.
No.
I watched it.
No.
And I was super. Super uncomfortable watching the movie.
How you end up being gay? What happened?
They were just trying stuff.
Yeah.
I'm just experimenting.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. As I'm telling you, super uncomfortable watching it, man.
Yeah, so
like he wasn't molested or none of that.
Okay, so they were just gay.
Straight up.
See with that. You know what I mean? See.
Mouth of the Goat.
Yeah. Look so, like.
But that's an Oscar worthy movie. Yeah. So, you know, you just got to pay attention to them little signs like that. For sure. But that's what that is. You know what I mean?
The movie wasn't even good.
And they give them an Oscar for that.
Yeah.
So. But, you know, just like with the Grammys. You know what I mean? Like, see, that's a problem. Like, they want to boycott the Grammys sometime. And then, you know, they still want the Grammy. You know what I'm saying? They got to get to a point where, you know, that stuff. Because it's not important.
It's not.
Because they don't never, like, they never pick the best album.
Never.
Or the best rap album. They never pick the best rap album. You know what I'm saying? So, it's like, you know, you holding this stuff to such high regard. But they don't hold you in the same light.
They don't.
So, you know, man, it's just the plight of the black man. You know what I'm saying? The plight of the black man.
In America.
You know. You dig? Let me see, man. We tackled a lot of stuff, man. Sheesh. Hey, fellas.
So, album of the year. I pick Push. Who you pick, Carr?
Nipsey.
Damn.
Victory Lap.
Yeah, I had Push.
Victory Lap crazy though. That's probably like
yeah, Victory
number
Lap.
Two.
That's a good album. It's a lot of good albums. See, that's the thing about hip hop nowadays, man. Like, hip hop isn't the best place that it's ever been. You know what I'm saying? People complain about it, but you don't have like it's so much bullshit, right? But that's for somebody. But you got so much good music that you can find what you want. You know what I'm saying? Like, I love the underground, like the Grammy shit.
I love the Grammy.
Man, so many Grammy niggas, man, it's too many niggas to even listen to.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I can't even listen to all these niggas.
Let me ask y'all something, because this dude is very entertaining. He funny, but he real, though. Young Kodak.
I love Kodak, man.
Oh, yeah. How y'all feel about that interview?
Which one?
Ebro.
High 97.
Ebro was gone, though.
Ebro always on some shit like that, though.
Yeah. I like Ebro, though. You know what I'm saying?
I like him, but...
Yeah.
He try to get...
It's how he asked the question, you know what I'm saying?
That, and then he try to, like, throw his authority around, because he show a lot of shit. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I understand that, but...
I ain't like...
Like, he be looking for a reason to throw a motherfucker out the
show. I don't understand why, though. Yeah, yeah. Well, it's just like, why you ask the question that way?
Yeah.
One is ongoing case. I mean, you know, you can't even talk about it. You know what I mean?
And then how he came back to the shit. Like, basically, you picking the shit. You know what I'm saying? Man, I already told him, let's talk about something else.
Yeah.
See, I look at it. See, this how... Because with me, I look at Kodak like a baby. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, she's 21.
Like, yeah, that's like...
You're a kid, man.
That's our baby. You know what I mean? Pause. So, as Ebro, supposed to be a black man, right?
Grown man, black man.
So, you got the young kid. You know he don't... You know, he don't do interviews.
He young, yeah.
He doesn't articulate that well. Right?
Exactly.
Stuff, you know, what he really want to say, he don't really articulate... He don't know how to... react to stuff.
Exactly.
He introvert. You know what I'm saying? You know this. You the interviewer. You control the interview. You make them feel comfortable. Like you started off with this. You mentioned it.
Yeah.
And then you start off saying, man, when I first heard you, I ain't know what you were saying. And then I started listening. You know what I'm saying? Like everything you saying, you kind of like.
Yeah, you can really rap all that shit. Yeah.
Yeah, you throwing a little slight at him a little bit.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He hit a lot of. I can't understand what you're saying. He hit it. He know that.
It disrespectful from the beginning.
Yeah, from the beginning.
And you just.
That shit built up.
Backhand compliment. He ain't that. He ain't stupid. Kodak not stupid.
He ain't stupid at all.
Then you get to the point where you come back with the sexual assault shit. And the mind of Kodak, when he said, We take that seriously up here. Kodak head,
like,
you just saying I did it, and you don't really fuck with me. Like you give me kind of like a, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then they try to switch the subject because they saw his reaction. They said
what about the moon?
He already, you know what I'm saying? He perturbed already now.
He already know what it is.
And you come back and ask me this stupid shit.
Yeah. So
you already came at me sideways about the sexual assault shit. Then you come back, kind of goddamn.
Are you uncomfortable with the question?
Well, you want to downplay the shit by asking me about fucking man on the moon. What I think about this shit. What I was born goddamn maybe 40, almost 40, 50 years after that shit.
Yeah.
What, Kodak 21?
Yeah, he a baby.
Exactly.
He don't know nothing about none of that.
He don't know nothing about none of that shit.
So.
That shit happened in 69?
68? Don't make me lie to you. I don't know. I thought it was like, I don't want to sound too stupid. Nigga, I don't have no idea.
I don't know either. Shit.
I thought it was like the 50s or something.
I guess shit. Shit, we don't know that shit way before our time.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why with Kodak,
I like how he responded though.
Yeah, he responded like, I'm going to get up and leave. Then Ebro trying to antagonize more. You're not going to tell me what to say on my show. You trying to antagonize.
Like, he left with respect. All right, say less.
And kept walking.
Yeah.
You trying to walk out behind him. And then, like, he tried to, you know, justify all that stuff. To, you know what I'm saying? Like, he do stuff like that to get his little, you know, because don't nobody check for him. Yeah. They do bad interviews. You know what I'm saying? Well, I take that back. They don't do, they kind of corny.
It's a staple.
It kind of corny though.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Rosenberg corny. The Laura Styles chick corny. Ebro okay. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But nobody want to look at Ebro. You know what I'm saying? Anybody feel he ain't got that sauce like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They already took your dope. Yeah. Brothers Club already took your dope. You know what I'm saying? It's late, too late now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So the best thing you do is have the best interviews you could do. Have the best interviews.
It's like he tried to be that confrontational cat on the interview. You know what I'm saying?
Just like you see Font Flex, right? Font Flex, he started doing the freestyle stuff. People go check for that freestyle. Like, oh, who he got? That's how he getting his little traction back. You know what I'm saying? You got to find something else. You know what I'm saying? Ebro, concentrate on the interview.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, get the people up there who don't get that platform. Then we be like, oh, they got such and such over there. You know what I'm saying?
I just like Kodak. I ain't like how he handles.
Yeah, he handled the wrong thing. You already know the man ain't
situation.
He ain't no interview cat. Know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
So with you getting up there getting a good interview from him, you know what I'm saying? People gonna look at that like, damn, let's get Kodak.
Yeah,
know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that's a nice interview because the first interview with Brother Club, it was funny.
Oh, he had
when he had the ski mask on the first time. Yeah. It was funny,
but he felt comfortable later.
Exactly,
and went back.
The last one. Hella entertained. I'm talking about for real.
Yeah, you
the
can
whole
tell.
Interview. Like everybody was into the shit.
He's more comfortable.
He was more comfortable. He was actually talking, answering questions and shit. Ebro get him on there. Like you said, the backhand, goddamn compliments. Like whole time though.
Yeah, and he even said he like, man, when I started feeling good or whatever, and he came jumped out the window with that bullshit.
Then,
so.
What Rosenberg?
Yeah,
he come back with him like going back and forth, like you contradicting yourself, or whatever, like. Damn, like y'all trying to find some conflict in the shit. Like,
yeah.
Acting like police.
Exactly.
Yeah, man, you know, so, you know. But
good cop, bad cop.
Yeah, I like Lil Kodak, man, you know.
I like Kodak. I think,
and he sounds like he genuinely want to change. It would be better.
He one of my top five young guys.
Kodak got some hits, too.
Yeah, he got
Kodak,
some hits.
Kodak, Baby, Gunner.
Yeah, Lil Baby, that's my little guy,
I believe
guy,
what he's saying, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he ain't lying about none of that. I love Lil Baby. I love him. Kodak, because I know little niggas like that. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Like, I know little niggas that was like that.
Growing up.
And I could tell. And then, you know, you always be amazed by these young niggas, you know what I'm saying? Because they don't articulate well. But then they'll say some shit, be like, damn, boy, that's borderline brilliant, man. How you
get that out?
You know what I'm saying? So, you know. I love Lil Baby, man. I forgot to put that Lil Baby on there. You know what I'm saying? That's my favorite album. Put one on.
I feel about Gunner. What about Gunner?
That's my favorite rapper. Lil Baby, my favorite rapper right now.
How you like Gunner, though?
Yeah, I fuck with Lil Baby, though. Tough. You know what I'm saying? Lil Baby. I love Lil Baby, man.
Lil Baby, all right.
I like Trippie Redd, too.
You must like him for real. I heard you say that a few times.
Yeah, I ain't really gotten to
Trippie. I ain't never listened
like
to him yet.
I ain't going to say I like him, but yeah, I'm bad. Dropped this summer was all right though. Like I listened to it multiple times, like all the way through.
Yeah.
I'm like, who's this? I'm like, damn, this album, all right. I'm just kept listening to it. You know what I'm saying? It was a good flow. Trippie Redd. But I ain't saying I'm a fan of him though.
Yeah, I ain't really gotten to him too much. Pause. So I'm gonna try to I'll check him out, see what you're talking about. I heard a couple of songs. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I think you put me on that album though.
I might not put you on Trippie Redd. I know I told you about that X, but you said you ain't listen to it till
later. I like X, yeah. I was late on X.
Yeah, X.
I was super late on X.
Yeah, X. Yeah, he X. X had some talent, man. God bless the dead. You know, he had a little future, man. You know,
he really did.
Unfortunate, man. You know, but you know, the youngsters, man. I'm telling you, boy. Yeah, man. So,
who you like, Lakar?
Youngsters.
Youngsters.
Lil Baby. I like Lil Baby. And I don't know if he's a youngster or not, but I listen to Moneybagg a little bit.
Oh, Moneybagg. Nah, he, I don't think he that young. Oh, Young Dolph, though. We're going to have to do like a hood nigga list, too.
We're gonna fuck with Dolph.
We're going to have to get a hood nigga list.
Dolph remind me of like the old South, how he move.
Dolph getting that money, though.
It's crazy what I'm saying. How he move, you know, the old South.
I like Young Dolph, man.
Yeah.
I don't, not particularly his music.
Just him.
But I like, yeah, I like.
Yeah, as far as that, but I can't listen to his music at
now,
all.
Moneybagg, yo, made some good music, though.
Dolph got a couple joints, though. Dolph gonna give you, like, one or two joints off the album. Like, okay, one or two joints off the album. He gonna give you that. I don't listen to the album, I'm just saying, but on title.
Yeah.
I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, I ain't listen to the whole album like that, though, but yeah.
Yeah, well. Yeah, we're gonna have to get that list together, man. We gotta figure out some hood niggas. I know all my hood niggas probably like, man, I don't listen to none of that shit them niggas talking about.
At all.
I ain't fuck with no Lupe. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. All my hood niggas.
Niggas in Birmingham, Boosie.
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 Oh, yeah. Boosie badass. All right, man. Y'all got something else, man?
Nah, man, just, I guess Christmas around the corner. That's about it. I mean, like, the time it flew by this year, man, I was like, damn, Christmas next week.
Yeah.
Christmas next week.
Yeah, that shit is next week.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Like, it was just Thanksgiving.
Yeah, I'm crazy. Crazy.
It was just, that's what I'm saying. Birthday, 35, car turn.
35 next year, man. Next month. And next year, like, you got down next month. 3-5, man.
KD.
Yeah, man. We out. Yeah. All right, fellas, man. We, I don't know how many topics, man. We sat here and got drunk off of.
I ain't drunk.
I'm drunk as hell. I done had a half a beer. I'm drunk as a motherfucker.
Angry Orchard.
I'm saying ain't even no beer, my G.
No beer.
That's apple. That's apple cider.
Hard cider.
Hard cider. Pause.
I'm drunk as hell.
It's good though.
But you know, God is the greatest, man. You know. You know,
NFL. NFL, did we not?
I don't fuck with NFL, man.
Yeah, at all.
We'll go ahead and wrap it up, man. You know what I'm saying. Gonna sign us out, man. Sign us out.
East side, real ones know.
East side, real ones know. It's the boy Money Making Mo, and we out.